You've heard of the official candy of the Olympics and the official drink of the Olympics and so on, but did you know that there's an official Olympic tunnel? That's right, and it's right here in Oregon. The Vista Tunnel in southwest Portland has been dubbed as the official tunnel of the 1984 Olympics. Now, no one knows who put the banner above the tunnel today, but in all honesty, the person probably wasn't really official. Mike?
Well, the games open tonight. The granddaughter of the great Jesse Owens carrying the torch into the Coliseum. Then 1960 decathlon champ Rafer Johnson lit the Olympic flame as the 1984 Summer Games officially opened in Los Angeles. George?
Thanks, Mike. The forecast for the Portland-Vancouver area for tomorrow and Monday, fair skies after some morning clouds, a high tomorrow about 81, and on Monday, 85. Ken?
And that's our show for tonight. Join Kim Singer and Gary Hill on Monday for the weekday edition of the 10 o'clock news. We'll be back next week. Good night.
Late night act. Lather up for laughs with soap. Weeknights at 12:30 on TV 12. PPTV, Portland.
Arena. It's Portland Wrestling. The best in Northwest Wrestling is brought to you by Tom Peterson's, with two locations, both at 82nd and Foster Road. And by Jim Fisher's, four used car locations, where you can always get the best deal. And by Miller's Meisterbrau, tastes as good as Budweiser at a better price.
Hello, everybody. I'm Don Kosh, your host for Portland Wrestling, along with my partner, former world heavyweight champion Stan the Man Stasiak, and I know that's not Buddy Rose.
No, that's for sure. This was given to me by a very, very lovely young lady. Very good. Sweet. Anyway, good evening, wrestling fans, and once again, we're back here at the Portland Sports Arena on another great card on hand tonight. We have a fantastic main event, and you will see it right here on television. Playboy Buddy Rose meets Matt Bourne, and what a treat that will be. We have two other exciting matches, interesting interviews, and a stern message from Rip the Crippler Oliver to myself. We'll talk about it later.
We'll have all the messages, all the news, interviews, and action right after this. Don't you dare go away.
Wake up! Hey, wake up.
He's doing it again.
You bet we're doing it again. And during our wake up sale, we have the best prices of the year. As advertised this week on the back page of TV Click, Disney Classic Cartoons, free with the purchase of any VHS video recorder in the store, like this Fisher new for $84 wireless remote control, VHS 8-hour, 105-channel cable-ready, programmable, front-loading, at almost an unbelievable price, only $4.99. Plus free, your choice of any of these Disney classic cartoons. Plus free membership in Tom Peterson's Top 600 Movie Club. And you can rent movies like Raiders for less than a dollar a day. If you're not renting movies from Tom Peterson's, you're paying too much. So don't delay. Buy today. Only $4.99. That's Tom Peterson's.
All good things come to an end. The free Disney offer with every VHS video recorder in the store is going to end this week. This Fisher is $499. It's VHS, and it's wireless. No wires, it's wireless. Sit in easy chair and flip the channels, and I'll tell you something. Next week you can buy it, and the price is still $499, but the free Disney movies do not come. Don't miss it. Fisher, $4.99 wireless tomorrow.
This is a stress test. Rick Mears, 1984 Indy 500 winner and a Pennzoil Penske Indy car, had to run at speeds of over 200 miles per hour with the engine hitting over 10,000 RPM. This is a stress test, and this is no picnic for a motor oil. This is where Rick Mears Indy Car Channel tests Pennzoil's quality and high technology to the limit. That's why you want Pennzoil protection in your car. Pennzoil, high technology and quality. Ask for it.
Saturday night, Portland Sports Arena, getting ready for our first match, which is going to, well, you can see Doug Summers getting into the ring right now, waiting for Armando Guerrero.
Right, and what a match, and Don, what a crowd. This place is jam-packed once again on a hot summer night. Boy, I'll tell you, the popularity of professional wrestling continues to rise and rise and rise. It never quits.
Absolutely.
The fans are all ready for action. Tonight, by the way, kids free night.
Boy, once again, Stan, they brought their all their signs and their banners and their cameras and the mask. See the guy over here in the mask?
That's right. He's a regular customer. Yeah. And look at the hand that Armando Guerrero received, the sensational young wrestler from Los Angeles, California, Super Mix.
That's the way you get into the ring.
You bet. Talk about charisma, personality, wrestling ability. What he lacks in size, he makes up for it many, many times with his speed, agility, and his many, many moves. Here comes Don Owens to tell us all about our first match of the evening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The first event this evening will be one fall. Introducing in this corner, 238 pounds from Oklahoma, Doug Summers. His opponent in this corner, 215 pounds, from Los Angeles, the Mexican jumping bean, Amanda Guerrero. Referee, Sandy Barr.
The Mexican jumping bean from Los Angeles, California, Amanda Guerrero. It might sound humorous, but when you see this man in action, boy, it's not too funny for his opponent. The man with a thousand moves, Armando Guerrero, Supermex, up against big, tough, pretty boy, Doug Summers from Muskogee, Oklahoma, a rugged customer.
You know, Guerrero shows us new moves every week.
You bet. Yeah.
Most of which are indescribable.
Right. We're underway right now. Armando Guerrero against pretty boy Doug Summers. In the red tights, Armando Guerrero in the black tights. Referee, lefty, Sandy Barr.
And they lock up into the ropes. Oh, hard smash by Summers and a return by Guerrero. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful night. Boy, I got the doors open, and it just feels good in here.
Beautiful crowd. People everywhere, all over the arena. Kids free night. And as I said many times before, nobody enjoys themselves better than wrestling fans. They come down here to have a good time. See all the action. Side headlock by Doug Summers. A right to the forehead. A short right. However effective, as you can see the reaction on Armando Guerrero.
Guerrero's going to wind up, and Summers is going to back out.
That tough little Mexican wrestler from Los Angeles, California. Always a pleasure to watch.
He really adds a lot of excitement to the sport of professional wrestling. I'm glad you're going to have a chance to see him in action right now. Look at him. Like a cat out there.
Now, front face lock by Doug Summers. Armando Guerrero trying to muscle out. Gets one arm up into a twist, and now Summers with a forearm smash to the side of the face.
Oh, yeah, he'll feel that south of the border.
And now Summers
there goes
pops another one.
I think Sandy Barr caught that one.
Yes, A fine move by Sandy Barr to catch him, and now a stern warning. Sandy Barr and Doug Summers have been going at it quite a bit as of late. Have you noticed every now and then they've been in a shoving match of some sort and some pretty harsh words. Reverse headlock by Doug Summers.
Yeah, he's really got that clamped in there, too. You see him wrenching on that.
And now Guerrero. There's a hair pull that Sandy Barr did not see.
Guerrero's going to pull Summers' hair, and unfortunately, Sandy Barr sees that. Oh, he is smashing Guerrero down to the mat.
Pops a right. Guerrero now threatening. And now Summers backs off.
Well, that's why he backed off. He just caught that in the...
And now Guerrero by the ears and clear across the ring.
That was an ear lock.
Well, it was a combination ear and hair.
Well, whatever it was, you know it smarted. Oh, he just took a boot right in the stomach, elbow in the back of the head.
Doug Summers, a rough and tough customer. Can take a lot of punishment, can also dish it out. Now a chin lock by Summers. Could very well turn it into a neck breaker.
Yeah, he should just take a little bit more of a move and he'd have that.
Look how he's got that neck twisted all the way around, Don. Roll over. And Doug Summers now holds on to that chin lock. Now going for the pin. I guess the shoulders aren't down. We can't see it from here. Summers now with the tights. Pulling the tights. Sandy Barr did not see it.
He didn't see that either. Oh, that was a good move by Guerrero.
Yes, it was a fine effort by Armando Guerrero. Two count on Summers, and Summers, he pulled the trunks. You can hear Armando saying to Sandy Barr, he pulled the trunks.
Oh.
A knee to the head.
Beautiful shot by Guerrero.
Another one. Not real hard, but effective enough to get him out of the hole. An uppercut with the forearm. Whips him into the ropes. Back body drop. Clear across the ring goes Doug Summers.
He just about went outside with that one.
Oh, both knees. Oh, that'll do it to your ears. Oh, yeah.
They'll be ringing for a week.
Here comes Serena, drop kick by Guerrero. Sends Summers sprawling and decides to take a walk.
Boy, he caught him flush on the chest with that. Just sent him right outside. Here you watch Guerrero just kind of pacing around there. He is. He's like a panther.
Sandy Barr counting now. He's got till 20 to get back into the ring. The crowd counting behind Sandy Barr. Summers gets in at 20.
That
took
was close.
His time.
That was very close.
Took all the time he needed. He's a cagey wrestler.
Oh, it's got Sandy Barr trapped back there.
Sandy Barr now beating on Doug Summers. Summers furious. Doug Summers furious at Sandy Barr. It was actually Guerrero.
Look at the look on Guerrero's face.
Guerrero's having a free laugh here at the expense of Doug Summers, who took a couple of good whacks behind the neck by Sandy Barr.
Sandy was in the corner against the ropes, and Guerrero just punching and shoving Summers into Sandy, and Sandy just laid one right on the back of Summers.
By the way, fans, you know, if there's any particular match that you want to see, pairing two wrestlers or anything in particular, why don't you write to the Portland Sports Arena and Cara Don Owen and express your opinion, what match you'd like to see the most.
The top wrist lock by Summers got that locked in pretty good.
You know, this
summer, he's choking.
Look at that choke. What a cagey wrestler this summer is. He knows exactly what he's doing in there. He can get away with stuff that the referee has no way of seeing. There's Sandy Barnhouse. Got that. And he pulls Summers. Sandy Barr, very, very alert tonight. He's not taking any guff at all from anybody.
No, he's not.
Especially Doug Summers. And Summers.
Look at Summers.
There he is.
He's about to lose his cool in there. Of course, if he starts taking on Sandy Barr, he could go the route of Rip Oliver and get suspended.
Oh, beautiful leg trip by Guerrero. And now, a leg lock by Guerrero, applying a lot of pressure. Oh, Guerrero stretching those ligaments. Oh, listen to the crowd. Doug Summers in a lot of pain now on the mat. Fans getting behind him on the Guerrero. Extremely popular.
This could turn into a submission hold, too, Stan.
Yes, it very well could. Armando Guerrero, very, very popular with the fans here. And now Sandy Barr giving Doug Summers a hard time. Summers tried to get to the ropes, and Sandy just kicked the ropes. Or kicked Summers' hand off
the ropes. Kicked his hand off the ropes, yeah. Now he's going to straddle him kind of like a camel clutch on Summers.
Yes, that is the camel clutch. Summers, good move by Summers, gets Guerrero off balance, gets him off his back. And now Guerrero working on that already sore back.
I don't know how Summers can even stand up.
Into the ropes. And now an abdominal stretch by Guerrero. A submission hold. Doug Summers has already taken a lot of abuse. Could very well be.
Well, Summers may be too tall for this.
He may be, but he's taken a lot of abuse, Don, and that is a very devastating hold. 5 minutes have elapsed in this match. Summers, a good effort.
Summers just fell back. He's exhausted. He is really exhausted. He's been put through the mill here.
And now, good move by Guerrero. Stunned Summers. He could have a fall here, but Summers kicks out barely at two.
Summers looked over at Sandy Barr. Did you think that count was a little fast?
Summers coming back now. Sandy Barr warning Summers.
Oh, right into the turnbuckle, face first.
And now Guerrero in the corner taking punishment at the hands of pretty boy Doug Summers. Well, this Summers can take a lot of abuse down. We've seen it time and time again. Right back.
Yeah.
A lot of stamina. He's a tough one. Drives a thumb. That was a thumb to the throat. Sandy Barr gave Sandy Barr a little elbow to the jaw. Here comes Guerrero. Kicks to the midsection. Oh, both sides.
Beautiful move by Armando Guerrero. Here he comes. Look at that. He is so fast. Oh, Summers got his leg out. Guerrero says, I'll take care of the leg.
Guerrero all over Summers now. What a move that was by Guerrero.
Oh,
how do you describe
marvelous.
That?
You just say it was a Guerrero move. Into the ropes.
And Summers almost straight on his head. Summers took a bad fall.
Oh, he did.
Right on his head.
Yeah, he's up. Now, Guerrero's not going to let up on him. He's going to stay right on him. There's a shot right in the midsection. See, Summers keeps coming back. It's like you were talking about, Stan.
Yes, he does. He's amazing, Don. Oh, rakes those eyes of Guerrero in the corner. Sandy Barr warning him again. Summers paying very little attention. Sandy Barr now stepping in. Guerrero trying to shake the cobwebs in the corner. Summers again The shot to the jaw, an elbow. Now Guerrero, a leg scissors from the corner.
He's got a, he had him in a vice. We've run out of time. That's it.
Guerrero goes for a sunset flip, but too late.
It's all over.
This match is a draw.
Armando Guerrero and Doug Summers battling, and boy, they were battling to a draw in our first match tonight.
What a match this has been. It was a great match, Don. Armando Guerrero with some fine moves. A little shoving and pushing between Sandy Barr and Doug Summers. Guerrero has a word to say here. Guerrero wants five more minutes. Guerrero wants five more minutes. Yes, Sandy Barr has okayed it. Five more minutes. And the fans love it. They want more. Listen to them. Guerrero. Oh, yes, they're all behind. The young man from Los Angeles. Back body drop by Guerrero. Drop kick by Guerrero. Guerrero off the ropes. Flying tackle, misses the tackle. And now Summers, confident, arrogant, stomps the head. Doug Summers now knows Guerrero is hurt. He's going to take advantage. Forearm. Punch to the side of the face. Guerrero in a lot of trouble. Doug Summers going wild on Armando Guerrero in the corner. Now.
He nails Sandy Barr.
And Guerrero now.
Look at Guerrero.
All over the ring.
No, that's it.
Sandy Barr has disqualified Doug Summers. And the winner, Armando Guerrero.
Guerrero doesn't know why they did that.
This is going to cost him. You can bet on that.
Yeah, you bet.
Little extracurricular activity.
Yeah, that'll cost him a few bucks too.
You bet.
And he's lucky that's all it cost him, because you just can't go around
hitting referee,
wrapping one on the referee. No.
And what a match this has been.
Boy,
this is just the beginning. Stay tuned, folks.
Woo. Okay. Let's tell everybody where we're going to be this coming week. There, it's appearing on your screen right now. Starting tomorrow, we're going to be in Seaside at the Convention Center. Monday, we'll be in Tacoma at the Bicentennial Pavilion. Tuesday, we're off. And then Wednesday, Seattle at the Seattle Center Arena for a big one there.
And Thursday night, the matches will not take place in Salem. It has been canceled, but they will take place a week from Thursday at the South Salem High School, Friday, Eugene Lane County Fairgrounds, and next Saturday right back here in Portland.
You bet. We'll be right back here, too, right after this.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
He's doing it again.
You bet we're doing it again. And during our wake-up sale, we have the best prices of the year. Like this full-size Magic Chef microwave oven for only $198. Plus this 16-piece microwave cooking set, free. Plus Portland's top microwave cooking schools, free. Now that's Tom Peterson's during our wake-up sale.
Here's another deal that's ending this week. Magic Chef, brand name, microwave. This is a full-size microwave. The price, it's right there, $198. Now, that's a great price for a full-size microwave. Plus, with every Magic Chef, you get free dishes. They're from Anchor Hawking. It's a 16-piece set. They're microwave cookware set. For how much? It's free. Buy any Magic Chef like this one for $198.
Wherever you are in Portland, there's a Jim Fisher used car center near you. Choose from more than 300 quality used cars. Here are some examples of bargains at Jim Fisher Volvo.
Here's a super van special in mint condition. A 73 VW 4-speed AM-FM cassette, sunroof, and rear window defroster, just $39.88. Here's another VW, a 79 Dasher with 4-speed AM-FM stereo and rear window defroster. It won't last long at $37.85 at Jim Fisher Volvo. Looking for a wagon? Check this 77 Chev Impala with V8 automatic power steering and brakes, air, and AM-FM cassette. Reduced to sell fast at $24.45. Look at this 81 Toyota Celica, loaded with 5-speed power steering, AM-FM stereo, and cruise control. Like new and only $74.85 at Jim Fisher Volvo, the Northwest's largest Volvo dealer downtown under the big blue Volvo sign at 21st and West Burnside.
There are many more great buys at all four Jim Fisher used car centers. You've got my name on it.
And we'll repeat now for our folks here at the sports arena and those of you at home that might have missed our wrestling calendar for next week. Starting tomorrow, and Stan, you got the magic microphone.
Starting tomorrow night, Sunday the 29th, wrestling returns to Seaside, Oregon at the Seaside Convention Center. Monday the 30th, Tacoma, Washington at the Bicentennial Pavilion. Tuesday night, the wrestlers are off. Wednesday night, August the 1st, Seattle, Washington at the Seattle Center Arena. No wrestling in Salem Thursday night, but a week from Thursday at the South Salem High School, wrestling returns to Salem. Friday night at the Eugene Lane County Fairgrounds Auditorium, a cage match featuring Matt Bourne. And next Saturday night, right back here to the Portland Sports Arena, next Sunday, a week from tomorrow, the 5th of August, wrestlers are off again. Monday the 6th, Yakima, Washington. Tuesday the 7th and the 8th, that is Tuesday and Wednesday, Hermiston, Oregon. Both nights, professional wrestling at the Umatilla County Fair. Wrestling two nights in a row. Get your tickets early for your Portland wrestling at the flea market every Sunday night, Sunday morning at the Portland Sports Arena, and at the other flea market at 146th and Stark. Get your tickets early. You don't have to stay in line.
The next Tuesday Portland special will be August 14th, and that's when Rip Oliver will be back in town. And we'll be in Pendleton on the 19th of August, and we'll be right back here right after this. Don't you dare go away.
During Tom Peterson's wake-up sale, TV specials, 13-inch GE remote, $295, 25-inch RC electronic tuning, $497, audio specials, 100-watt Fisher audio system, $799, or this Fisher portable radio cassette, only $149. Video specials, Sanyo VCR only $297. RCA disc player only $149. Now that's Tom Peterson's.
You're looking at our best-selling video recorder this month, the brand name Sanyo. Why is the best-selling? Number one, the price is right, $297. Secondly, all, Sanyo is a brand name, and you get the free, it's now top 800 movie club membership. You can rent movies for only 49 cents. Now, we're down probably tomorrow to floor models on these units. They're still $297. It's our top seller. They're not going to last all week. Don't miss it.
My daughter calls it the Blue Bomber. My wife thinks I ought to get rid of it. And when it needed a new muffler, well, I was afraid she might be right.
Listen, I don't want to spend too much on this car.
Midas had a muffler that was perfect for my budget. Now the old Blue Bomber sounds almost as good as new. And heck, she doesn't look that bad.
Trust a Midas touch.
Look at this big W. You can't miss it.
Sunday at 5, A Dying Man's Word...
Say, what is a big W?
...starts the most hilarious treasure hunt ever filmed.
Good luck and may the best man win!
They stop at nothing.
We got a situation here that is absolutely incredible.
This all-star cast, going totally bananas, can only prove it's a mad, 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 mad world. Sunday at 5 on TV 12.
Man in the ring right now is Buck Ramstad. We await the arrival of Kevin Kelly.
The California Hercules, Kevin Kelly, 6 feet 5 inches tall, 271 pounds, goes against Buck Ramstad. He calls himself Mr. Pro. He is the former Canadian heavyweight wrestling champion. Don Owen making his way into the ring, and he will be announcing this match in just a moment.
Event will be one fall. Introducing in this corner, 240 pounds from Vancouver, BC, Buck Ramstad. His opponent in this corner, 268 pounds, the California Hercules, Kevin Kelly.
And Kevin Kelly gets a good hand from this crowd. While we have the opportunity, Don, I understand our Rip Oliver has a message for me.
Yeah, he sure has. And it's regarding that Tuesday, August 14th bout. He says that he wants you, Stan Stasiak, to meet him in the ring so he can work you over without getting suspended. Now he says, I'll give him $1,500 just to get in the ring. Then he adds a little, how about it, yellow belly, kind of thing.
Well, we'll come to that later, Doc.
Ah, okay.
$1,500, huh?
That's what he says, $1,500. Yeah.
Sounds good. Buck Ramstead with a wrist lock on Kevin Kelly. Pulls him by the hair. Sandy Bar saw that. Or did he?
I don't think he did.
Well, Don, I'm going to say this. I have been training. I'm getting ready. And I will accept the challenge.
You're going to accept that challenge?
You bet I will.
On the 14th?
You bet I will. I'm ready.
Well, I'm sure that we're going to have more information about that later. Well, I know you've been working out. You've been going out to the gym.
I'll be ready.
And I know that you're not doing it for the $1,500.
There's a lot more to it, Don. I haven't forgotten. I'll never forget it. Now Ramstead against the ropes. Kelly, clean break.
Well, that'll take a that'll take an agreement with Don Owen, and we'll see.
Well, I have to talk to Don Owen about it.
You have, or you will?
I will.
Look at that! Look at that power from Kevin Kelly. Just picks him up and sucks him up there on the that top rope.
Now, Buck Ramstead doing some talking in there. He appears to me he would be an antagonist. He does a lot of talking in the ring. Talks to his opponents. Antagonizes them. A lot like tough Tony Bourne used to do. Tony used to sometimes beat you with words.
And they're just yak at you all the time.
Oh, right? Just get you completely, just mess up your whole mind and concentration and... And then out of nowhere, whip you. Tough Tony Bourne. And as we know, the chip off the old block, Matt Bourne in action tonight in our main event against none other than his arch rival, Playboy Buddy Rose. What a match that will be.
And that match will follow this one. If you tuned in late, our first match between Armando Guerrero and Doug Summers. The match actually, the first time, ended in a draw. But was it Guerrero that wanted 5 minutes more? Yeah. He just wanted five more minutes. And so Sandy Barr gave him five more minutes. And Doug Summers got himself disqualified. So Guerrero ended up victorious in the first match. Right now you got Kevin Kelly with a side headlock on Buck Ramstead. And the count is on.
Kevin Kelly now with a side headlock with the old pump. Boy, that takes its toll on you, especially when you have a powerful man like Kevin Kelly drives a forearm right to the midsection, sent Ramstead to the mat, and Ramstead goes for a walk. He says, I've had enough for a while.
Oh, his eyes were all glassy. He just wanted to get out of there.
Well, we can't sell this Ramstead short. We've seen him in action before. He's a ring veteran. He knows what he's doing. He's very cagey in tremendous physical condition. He's a former Canadian heavyweight wrestling champion, Mr. Pro Buck Ramstead, against the California Hercules, Kevin Kelly.
Now, side headlock by Ramstead.
Into the ropes.
Oh, he just ran
to
into a
no
brick
avail.
Wall.
Like running against the side of a mountain. Kevin Kelly right back to that headlock. Very smart move. Kevin Kelly learning fast, gaining experience with every match. He realizes now you got to create that weak spot.
Oh,
he
got to
soften up your opponent. Now the whip into the turnbuckle.
Oh, that was a throw-in.
Body drop, and Ramstad goes flying. Kelly going for it. Gets a one count. Kevin Kelly learning fast, improving with every match. Very impressive.
Ramstad's learning he doesn't want to stay in there too long with Kevin Kelly. Ramstad getting back in the ring. Well, I tell you, when he came off those ropes and he hit Kelly head on, it was just like he bounced right off of a brick wall.
Just... I'm sure that's exactly how it felt, too. Have you ever run into a brick wall, now?
I used to do that for a living. Ramstad's doing what he can to work Kelly over. Doing a pretty good job of it, too.
Oh, knee to the midsection. Sends Kelly to the mat. Rams his head to the mat. Ramstad taking over.
Well, he's in control right now.
Knee to the side of the head. Kelly feeling the effect.
Boy, use the fingers on that.
Rip the Crippler Oliver returns August the 11th, has issued a challenge to me and to others, Matt Bourne and Kelly and everybody.
But it's you that he really wants, Stan, because...
I'm sure he does.
He looks to you for creating that suspension and costing him a lot of money.
Don, I haven't been talking much about it, to be honest with you, but deep inside, I want him... as bad as he wants me, and maybe worse. After all, I was victimized. Here comes Kelly, coming back on Buck Ramstad. Into the turnbuckle, not very effective. Kelly now, a beel across the ring.
Kelly,
the body slam coming up.
Oh, so this is gonna be one of those power body slams. Look at that. Whoa.
Kevin Kelly going for the pin. One gets a one count. Ramstad, very tough. Mr. Pro, former Canadian heavyweight champion. Fighting back. High gouge. Kelly in trouble. Sandy Barr warning Ramstad. Another using that tape across the eyes.
There we go.
Kelly's head into the turnbuckle. Another time. Going for another time. Kelly.
Kelly's blocking that.
Kevin Kelly.
He's gonna try for a triple. There it is. Now how about
home run?
Nice.
And there's the full Nelson. And this will be it. You can count on it. You can bet all your money on it. That this match is going to be over. Ramstad, victim of the famous Full Nelson, and Kevin Kelly, in impressive manner, has defeated the tough former Canadian heavyweight champion, Buck Ramstad.
Once again, very reminiscent of Billy Jack with that devastating Full Nelson. And Kelly has defeated Ramstad. We'll be back with more right after this.
Wherever you are in Portland, there's a Jim Fisher used car center near you. Choose from more than 300 quality used cars. Here are some examples of bargains at Jim Fisher downtown Datsun.
For economy, here's a 74 Audi 4-speed with new radial tires, sheepskin seat covers, a super wrestling special at just $16.99. Another low-cost special, this 70 VW Fastback 4-speed with radio and a new paint job. It runs great, and it's only $15.77 at Jim Fisher Downtown Datsun, 16th and West Burnside. Look at this 81 Datsun pickup 4x4. It has a light bar, fender flares, a winch, AM/FM cassette, and fog lights. It won't last long at just $64.84. Or check this low-cost 76 Pinto. It has an automatic transmission, radial tires, AM/FM cassette, and sunroof. Take it away for just $12.99 at Jim Fisher Downtown Datsun, downtown where the action is at 16th and West Burnside.
There are many more great buys at all four Jim Fisher used car centers. You've got my name on it.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
He's doing it again.
You bet we're doing it again. And during our wake-up sale, we have the best prices of the year. This 19-inch color TV, remote control, only $277. This 25-inch color TV, only $399. This 13-inch color TV, just $169. That's Tom Peterson's during our wake-up sale.
Here's another buy you won't see next week, and right here, 19-inch remote color television. The price is right there, $277. Remote TV, 19-inch, and the price is only $277. We only have about 25 more to sell. When they're gone, it's going to be all over. And chances are we'll be on the floor models before the week is over. Don't miss this great buy on a wireless 19-inch remote color television at Tom Peterson's, only $277.
Take your time. Be choosy. At Roses, we take the time to ensure the quality you have come to expect. That's why Portland keeps coming back to Roses.
I told you people time after time that the Klan would survive. We are the champions. Hacksaw and Tommy Pritchett.
Comes Tommy Pritchett and Hacksaw Sawyer. I thought maybe you might be doing the interview stand with the PA mic from up here. Down to those guys.
Boy, I'll tell you, you can expect anything when the Klan's around. They decided they were going to do their own interview from the ring.
Now, Mr. Ebony and Mike Miller jumped in the ring. We thought they were coming up here for an interview. They went to the ring instead. Grab the microphone. Now, here's Tommy Pritchett.
Hey, Ebony, anytime you want it, I owe you one, boy.
And now they're going to go out. Well, they're going for chairs again. Hacksaw and Tommy Pritchett each picked up a chair. And that got Miller and Ebony out of there. They're going back to the dressing room.
Kind of a strange turn of events. The Klan decided to go in the ring and do their own interview. In the meantime, Hacksaw Sawyer and Tommy Pritchett chased them out of the ring and chased them clear back to the dressing room with chairs.
You know, that incident right there reminds me, Stan, that... You know, anytime these guys pick up chairs like that, you know, that's completely out of the control of Don Owen.
That's true. We've had some mail from some individuals putting all the blame on Don Owen. What can Don Owen do when those guys go in the ring? First of all, they are all individual contractors, really, basically, by legal rights. And what they do in the ring, he has no control over that.
Or what they do up here.
Or what they do up here, and you know, let's not put the blame on Don Owen.
Okay, we'll be back with more action right after this timeout.
It's Tom Peterson's direct to you. Furniture at truckload prices. Save $100, your choice. Buy this beautiful full-size sectional, only $498, or buy this sofa love seat combination. Both pieces only $498. Both sectional and sofa love seat covered in rugged, durable Herculon. Or if you prefer, buy the sectional as a sleeper or the sofa as a sleeper. Only $99 more. Now that's Tom Peterson's.
Furniture, we've got it at Tom Peterson. You saw a wonderful sofa and love seat. The price $498. You save $100. If you want to make it into a sleeper, queen size sleeper, just add $99. We've got great furniture at Tom Peters. It's all reduced prices. If you're looking for a chair, recliner, sofa, love seat, sectional, come and see us. And once more, just for a few seconds, 297, our best-selling VCR, will probably sell out tomorrow. Don't miss it.
My dad's always telling me that when he started in the construction business, he could carry all his tools in the back of a pickup.
Now some of the tools could carry a pickup.
No secret, just good work at a good price, right?
Word of mouth did the rest.
Folks at Meisterbrau do a good job. Sure, we can afford any beer we want,
but this tastes as good as Budweiser and doesn't cost as much.
I think word of mouth on Meisterbrau is going to be pretty good.
Meisterbrau tastes as good as Budweiser at a better price.
It is after midnight, and this man is possessed by hunger. A hunger so powerful, it will drive him into another dimension known as the Midnight Zone. There is only one place where he can find the juicy flame-broiled Whopper he craves after midnight. A place called Burger King. Very soon, you too will know hunger in the night. You too will drive through the Midnight Zone at Burger King.
We're getting ready for our main event, and so is she. Hey?
For a while, I thought we're going to see our other main event, which will not be seen on television in the ring tonight when Hacksaw Sawyer and Tommy Pritchard jump in the ring.
Right. And there's Buddy Rose. Okay. Matt Bourne is another Boy George. Is that what it says?
Buddy Rose.
Well, this is our main event. Buddy Rose and Matt Bourne. Turning into one of the major grudge matches in professional wrestling today.
And Matt Bourne now slowly making his way into the ring. Very important match. And now another banner out there saying Buddy Rump Roast.
Rose, yeah. Well, I'll tell you, they came here.
Falls or to a TV time limit. Now there will be no disqualification in this bout. They gotta stay in the ring, and the referee will try to keep control of the match as much as possible, but there will be no disqualification no matter what they do. Introducing in this corner, 248 pounds from Las Vegas, Playboy Buddy Rose. His opponent in this corner, 244 pounds from Milwaukee, Matt Bourne.
Well, Matt Bourne wearing the scars of Buddy Rose, and Rose is wearing a few bruises and lacerations from the hands and feet of Matt Bourne. So both of these guys have certainly been through their own wars, personal wars. And here we go again. But this crowd here, which is tremendous tonight, they've got their signs and placards and banners. Oh, I tell you, anything can happen to this thing here tonight. Let's just hope it stays out in the ring. Look at this now. Bourne's got Buddy Rose up there on that top rope.
Boy, I'll tell you, Matt Bourne being hesitant, but being also very careful.
Rose is just about at the mercy right now of Matt Bourne.
Oh, Matt Bourne now starting to take over here. Oh, and rammed Rose's head backwards, back of his head into that steel post. Buddy Rose is all over the ring.
You
feel that Matt Bourne being very calculating, taking his time. Oh, boy, does he want to tear Rose apart.
Well, that'll give you a migraine. Here comes a body slam of Matt Bourne. And guess which part of the body that slammed.
Buddy Rose hurting now.
Oh, he's going to smash him into that post again. Here he goes again.
Oh, another time. Buddy Rose took a couple of hard shots into that ring post.
Well, I tell you, if you were here in person, you could hear this contact and just about feel it. Here we go again, into the...
Buddy Rose head first.
And he blocked most of that. But he caught other parts of his body on that turnbuckle.
Bourne now rolling Buddy Rose up. Almost had the fall.
Well, so far, it's been all Matt Bourne in our main event. Well, yeah, Buddy took a swing. Buddy doesn't even know where he is right now.
Buddy Rose trying desperately to get it. He's at a disadvantage now. Matt Bourne has taken the initiative here right from the start. He hasn't really exploded outside yet. Oh, right over the top rope out of the concrete floor. Here comes Matt Bourne now.
He's going to grab for a chair. He's got the chair, that metal folding chair.
Clear across the head and shoulder. Buddy Rose.
Buddy caught that on his right arm.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Into the ring. Matt Bourne after him. Buddy Rose on the receiving end. Matt Bourne now.
I think he's biting him.
Biting Buddy Rose on the head.
Oh, yeah, he did. He did the old vampire lock there on that one. Well, this crowd is 110% behind Matt Bourne right now. They're chanting. Look at. Matt Bourne, that look of confidence.
Matt Bourne got the job done. He did what he wanted to do. And he opened up a gash on Buddy Rose's forehead. Buddy Rose now bleeding. Matt Bourne, a hard left straight to the forehead.
Those are landing, my friends, right smack in the forehead of Buddy Rose. Right on the forehead.
Matt Bourne, very, very calculating tonight. Hasn't gone completely wild. Keeping his cool. And Buddy Rose, he's very effective. All Matt Bourne so far.
He's got Rose just hanging over that top rope. Oh, he's got him wrapped up now. Look at that. You talk about being at his mercy.
Matt Bourne now from the floor. Got a helpless Buddy Rose. He is giving him a beating.
One left right after another, right on that forehead.
Buddy Rose in a lot of trouble now.
Now he's fighting him again.
Matt Bourne gnawing away at that forehead. Buddy Rose can't get loose. He's got that
left foot
stuck in that top rope. Looks like he's going to get it out partially. Now Matt Bourne stepping on his head.
Yeah, he's just stepping, standing right on his head, right on that forehead.
Boy, those ropes are tight, too, Don.
I hope the camera angle is catching this. Sometimes the camera angle is a little deceptive on some of these drops and stops. Boy, I tell you, every one of these is landing and hurting.
Matt Bourne in full control over Playboy Buddy Rose. Buddy Rose backing away. Looks like he's got a gash right on the hairline. Matt Bourne, a kick, a low blow. Yes, but remember, folks, no disqualification. Sandy Barr just standing there watching, letting it go on.
Bourne's going to go up to the second rope, and he landed again.
A hard stomp right to the forehead. Buddy Rose on the mat. One, two,
he's got
three.
It.
Matt Bourne has just defeated Buddy Rose to take the first fall.
You know, that was Matt Bourne all the way. I don't think Buddy Rose.
All the way.
He never even got a shot in, did he?
Not one shot.
Well, from start to finish in our first fall, it was all Matt Bourne. He's one fall up in our main event. We'll be back with our second fall right after we bring you up to date again. Reminder of our wrestling calendar starting next week.
And then, tomorrow night at Seaside, Oregon, wrestling returns to the Convention Center in Seaside, Oregon. Tacoma, Washington, Bicentennial Pavilion, Monday the 30th. Tuesday, the wrestlers are off. Wednesday, August the 1st, Seattle, Washington at the Seattle Center Arena. No wrestling in Salem, but it returns a week from this Thursday at the South Salem High School. Friday the 3rd, Eugene, Oregon, a big cage match there at the Lane County Fairgrounds Auditorium. Next Saturday night, Portland Wrestling once again. Get your tickets early. Don't miss it. be there.
We'll be right back right after this.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
He's doing it again.
You bet we're doing it again. And during our wake-up sale, we have the best prices of the year. As advertised this week on the back page of TV Click, Disney Classic Cartoons, free with the purchase of any VHS video recorder in the store, like this Fisher new for $84 wireless remote control, VHS 8-hour, 105-channel cable-ready, programmable, front-loading, at almost an unbelievable price, only $4.99. Plus free your choice of any of these Disney classic cartoons. Plus free membership in Tom Peterson's Top 600 Movie Club. And you can rent movies like Raiders for less than a dollar a day. If you're not renting movies from Tom Peterson's, you're paying too much. So don't delay. Buy today. Only $4.99. That's Tom Peterson's.
It's after midnight, you're hungry, and your stomach is talking to you. Unfortunately, the refrigerator is empty. The supermarket is closed. And no one delivers at this hour. But you can drive to Wendy's, where the pickup window is now open late. So the next time your stomach talks to you after midnight, pick up something at Wendy's, and your stomach will thank you. Something later for Wendy's kind of people.
New Valvoline Turbo 5 Motor Oil. Specially engineered to take the searing heat of turbos. Temperatures twice as high as non-turbo engines. Hot enough to cook normal oils. If you've changed to a turbo, change to new Turbo 5. Extra protection for any engine. Proven protection for turbos. Valvoline Turbo 5. Symbol of protection.
Available at G.I. Joe's.
Ladies and gentlemen, the most exciting tag team combination in the world and the most popular, Hacksaw Sawyer and Tommy Pritchard.
And I just want to say one thing. Everybody who was here last Saturday night and who watched wrestling on TV saw how Mr. Ebony and Mike Miller got those belts and they're running them around their waist right now. Well, I want to say one thing to you, Mr. Ebony. I got 7 stitches from your elbow pad last week because I saw the tape myself. And I want to tell you one thing else. I don't know what you got into, Mike, but you're cruising with the wrong guy. Because, Mr. Ebony, you're not going to get away with it. I'm going to take that arm of yours, take that elbow pad right off you. I talked to Don Owens, and I got you next Saturday night. But I want to say one more thing. Heck, you already know about it, but I'm telling you for Ebony, because I know you're watching on the monitor back there in your dressing room. Hack Sawyer is going to be in my corner next week, sitting right there, to make sure nobody comes out of the dressing room, nobody interferes in the match, and it's just going to be you and me, Ebony, in the ring next Saturday night. And I'm going to put this right foot right upside your head, and there's not going to be a damn thing you can do about it.
Yeah, right on. Hey, Tom, you know, Ebony, I tell you what, I'll see you tomorrow night in Seaside. Tom might not be so rough for him next Saturday night when I get done with you in Seaside. But Playboy Buddy Rose, you look like you need to go to the hospital, boy.
That's all the time we have. Thank you, Hacksaw Sawyer and Tommy Pritchard. Back to Don.
Charles Bronson takes care of business his own way in Death Wish, Monday night on TV 12. KPTV, Portland.
During Tom Peterson's wake-up sale, TV specials. 13-inch GE remote, $295. 25-inch RC electronic tuning, $497. Audio specials. 100-watt Fisher audio system, $7.99. Or this Fisher portable radio cassette, only $1.49. Video specials. Sanyo VCR, only $2.97. RCA displayer, only $1.49. Now that's Tom Peterson's.
Wherever you are in Portland, there's a Jim Fisher used car center near you. Choose from more than 300 quality used cars. Here are some examples of bargains at Fisher Mazda Peugeot.
Check this classy 79 Alpha convertible 5-speed. It has an AM-FM stereo, mag wheels, and only 48,000 miles. A great buy at just $68.88. Here's another convertible. This 80 VW Rabbit 5-speed. It has an AM-FM stereo cassette and low miles. A super wrestling special at just $77.77 at Fisher Mazda Peugeot. Look at this 79 Chevrolet Monte Carlo. It's loaded with automatic air, tape deck, cruise control, power steering and brakes, and only 56,000 miles. It's priced right at only $47.77. Or look at this wrestling special. A 75 Plymouth Scamp with 318 V8 automatic transmission and power steering, just $11.99 at Fisher Mazda Peugeot at the east end of the Burnside Bridge at Union and East Burnside.
There are many more great buys at all four Jim Fisher used car centers. You've got my name on it.
Need relief from athlete's foot?
Feel the Desinex difference.
And there is a difference because medicated Desinex does more than just cure athlete's foot. Want cooling, soothing relief?
Feel the Desinex difference.
Desinex soothes burning feet, cools tender feet. Want relief from cracked, itchy feet?
Feel the Desinex difference.
Desinex relieves itching, gives real foot comfort, and used daily, Desinex helps prevent reinfection. Feel the Desinex difference.
Buddy Rose never left the ring during that interview, during that timeout. He never left the ring at all.
A very badly battered Playboy Buddy Rose. But we've seen him that way before, and we know what he can do. And this second fall should be interesting. Remember, folks, this is no disqualification match. Anything goes.
And that first fall, it was Matt Bourne all the way from the opening bell.
And what a vicious beating Buddy Rose took at the hands of Matt Bourne. Rose
is still trying to get something, you know, a kick, a hit, anything.
Well, he's going to have to do something here. He's behind one fall. He's badly battered. He's still bleeding from the forehead.
Both of these men, southpaws. Well, they can match each other's style pretty evenly. Into the ropes. Again, Matt Bourne in control. And again, he's working on that forehead.
Oh, yes, Matt Bourne, boy, I'll tell you. Buddy Rose has been completely on the receiving end. Now, all through the first fall, and now so far in the second fall, look. Buddy Rose is helpless. He's tied up in those ropes. He doesn't know where he's at. He's in a daze. Matt Bourne, very calm, doing one heck of a job. Boy, he really prepared himself for this one.
He really did.
I would be very surprised, though, if Buddy Rose doesn't make some sort of a...
Matt Bourne's going to have to make a mistake for Buddy Rose to get, to get a shot in there.
Somehow, Buddy Rose, we've seen him many times in bad shape like this, but so far he hasn't been able to come back at all.
I've never seen a fall involving Buddy Rose that he didn't
do
get
something.
At least
right.
One shot in
do
there.
Some damage.
But it was Matt Bourne all the way. Now look at that, Bourne fighting. Biting his finger. Yeah, I would say that Matt Bourne came prepared. I'd say he's pumped for this one.
No love between these two.
Well, listen to the crowd. Now you can feel the crowd. They're clapping, they're stomping, they're cheering, all for Matt Bourne. Go, Matt, go. And Matt's been going pretty good here. Oh, don't turn your back on Buddy Rose.
Now a test of strength coming up. Looks like, oh, Buddy Rose now.
That's the first one.
Yes. Now Buddy Rose senses. Yes. Matt Bourne getting ready to come right back. Oh, rake with the nails right across the back another time. Buddy Rose.
Buddy's not letting up now. He's got.
He's a ring veteran. Rams Matt Bourne into the turnbuckle. A left, another left, another left.
Now he's working on the face of Matt Bourne.
Buddy Rose now.
Oh, what do you want to bet? Here we go. Into the
Matt Bourne's head in the very same manner that Matt Bourne rammed his head in the first fall into that steel post. Not quite as hard that time. A chop across the throat. Now Buddy Rose. Oh, yanks that leg.
That leg about came off.
Right across that top strand. And now Buddy Rose has Matt Bourne at his mercy.
Another left hand right in the face of Matt Bourne. And elbow.
Now Buddy Rose having his way.
Landed right on the chin. Now he's going to bite.
Yes, biting away at Matt Bourne's forehead now.
Now the crowd trying to provide that fan power, but Bourne is in a pretty rough way right now. Buddy Rose working on him. Bourne trying to get back in the ring. Oh. Boy, that's a power elbow across the throat. Oh, look at this. And he's got that neck. His neck is right against the edge of the apron of the ring.
Oh, Buddy Rose having his way now, and he's proud about it. Looking our direction here.
There's no disqualification.
Anything goes.
And it's going.
Now Buddy Rose looks like he's going to shove Matt Bourne right onto the floor. And now a little strut around the ring. Very arrogant. Sandy Barr starting to count. Matt Bourne has to 20 to get it back in the ring, but Buddy Rose going to take the battle to the floor.
Bourne's eyes are pretty glazed over right now. Oh,
rammed his head into the apron of the ring. Buddy Rose reaching for a steel chair.
He just
rams that chair hard across the head.
Oh, come on. That's not nothing.
And now across the back. Buddy Rose giving Matt Bourne a severe beating right now. Hurls him into the ring and goes after him. Matt Bourne bleeding from the forehead now.
That was where his bit, I think.
What a vicious battle we are seeing here tonight. Our main event. Buddy Rose now having his way. A low blow. Matt Bourne in pain. Now biting.
Yeah, between biting and being hit with that metal chair, Matt Bourne's forehead is beginning to look like Buddy Rose's forehead. Now Rose, again, a little left hand right on the forehead.
Matt Bourne really in a bad way right now. Buddy Rose is stomped to the head. Matt Bourne trying to make it to the ropes. Buddy Rose very cool right now, calculating just like Matt Bourne was in that first fall. A complete reversal.
Now what's Buddy going to do? He's going to go up. He brought Matt Bourne's head right down on his knee.
Buddy Rose going for the pin.
This could be it.
And he gets a three. But he pulled the tights that Sandy Barr could not see. Buddy Rose wins the fall. Sandy Barr did not see the tight. Buddy Rose pulling the tights. Fans disapproving. There was no way Sandy Barr could see it.
We're all even at one fall apiece in our main event. We will be back with the third and deciding fall right after these words.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
Who? Who? He's doing it again.
You bet we're doing it again. And during our wake-up sale, we have the best prices of the year. Like this washer and dryer combination. Both pieces only $4.98. Or your choice of this two-door refrigerator or 10-foot freezer. Only $2.95. That's Tom Peterson's during our wake-up sale.
I always said I'd wait for the love of my life, but I guess I'll just have to settle for sex. Some girl
did it all the action. Somewhere between virginity and senility is paradise. I'm
on the outside. Alan, would you like my Bunsen burner? Alan, would you like my Bunsen burner?
Get ready for Joy of Sex, rated R. Starts Friday, August 3rd at a theater or drive-in near you.
Would you believe we started this business in a shed back of my house?
Well, that our first 6 months, we sold two chairs.
The good old days. Now folks come from all over for our handmade furniture, because we offer them good workmanship at a fair price. Fellas at Meisterbrow understand that. Today, we could pay as much as we want for beer, but this tastes as good as Budweiser and doesn't set you back as much.
And after a long day of sawdust, you build up a pretty good thirst.
Meisterbrow tastes as good as Budweiser at a better price.
Give me some fun in the blazing sun. Give me a friend or two. And when my thirst is at its worst, give me a Mountain Dew. Oh,
ladies and gentlemen, Playboy Buddy Rhodes.
I'll tell you right now, I am not going to look at the camera. I'm not going to let the people see what my head looks like. I'm not going to give them that privilege. But you people, you keep watching, because you're going to see what Matt Bourne's head looks like, what his body looks like when I get through with him out here. Now, Stasiak, I just wish you were in there knocking heads with us. I wish Don Owens was in there knocking heads with us. I wish you people were in there knocking heads with us. Because now I'm sick and tired of knocking heads, and it's time that the other guy get his block knocked off. Matt Bourne, you just look at my back right now, because that's all you're going to see in the future is my back. You won't look at me man to man. When I beat you, Matt Bourne, all you're going to see is me walking off to the dressing room with my hand raised in victory. I'm not going down no more for anybody. Hack Sawyer, Tommy Pritchard, you both think you're going to get those belts back. Let me tell you something. I've never seen three of the biggest crybabies in my life. Matt Bourne, Hack Sawyer, and Tommy Pritchard. Well, I'm not up here crying. I'm up here bragging and telling facts. And Matt Bourne, the facts are going to be found out right now in this next fall. Who's number one in the Northwest? Anything goes, Matt Bourne. You're supposed to be Mr. Tough Guy in the bars, Mr. Tough Guy in the streets, Mr. Tough Guy in Portland. We're in Portland right now, Northwest. Stay tuned and watch how tough Buddy Rose really is.
That remains to be seen, and now we're going to go right back to the ring for our third and final fall of our main event.
And back to the ring indeed. You can see part of the crowd here tonight. Well, this place is jumping. It's packed. And they're seeing one heck of a main event between Matt Bourne and Buddy Rose. Both men cut up pretty good across the foreheads. We're all even at one fall apiece. Matt Bourne took the first fall without Buddy Rose hardly even laying a hand on him. And the second fall went to Buddy, when he definitely laid more than a hand on him. And that sets the stage for the third and the final fall. Best two out of three to a TV time limit. Matt Bourne making his way to the ring right now through the crowd. There he is. And here comes Buddy Rose. Well, this is one of the liveliest, noisiest crowds we've had for a long time, Sam.
Yes, Don. We're getting ready to start our third fall here. There are some pretty strong words by Buddy Rose. Of course, you know, he's always been a loud mouth. First, you still can't take it away from him, though. The man doesn't have a reputation, and he got that reputation in the ring, so you can't sell him short, you know. I mean,
he has a reputation of being able to back up that loud mouth.
That's right, so. And now here comes a chant, Rump Roast, something that started a few years ago.
He doesn't like that.
Oh, no.
He's going out into the crowd. Thought he was going to take on the crowd there for a second. They're getting to him now. And of course, that's what Matt Bourne wants. He wants Buddy's attention distracted.
Now, Buddy Rose very upset, indicating that to some fan that. And now look at Matt Bourne going after Buddy Rose. Buddy Rose.
He's doing a little jog.
Has
Matt
no
Bourne.
Idea.
He crouched down there.
A little jogging going on out of the ring.
Well, what's Buddy doing? He's warming up a little bit, huh? Yeah, he's really letting the crowd get to him. Boy, everybody is really...
Buddy Rose very upset with the crowd. Oh, no, buddy. Don't you dare.
Oh, wait a minute, buddy.
Hey, look at that. Little grandma back there.
She stood right up to him. Look at that.
She's not backing off either. All right.
Now, here comes Matt.
Buddy Rose all over the place.
Well, Buddy's concentration has really been destroyed here between the crowd and Matt Bourne.
Now, Buddy Rose, you can bet your life he's trying to figure out a way to get to Matt Bourne. But Matt Bourne, very alert tonight.
Matt Bourne, Buddy Rose wants to know how much time is left.
Yeah. Buddy Rose is stalling for time right now. Yeah.
Well, he's got
That's very obvious.
He's got 10 minutes to stall, though.
Sandy Barr, nothing to do except camp the wrestlers out. When their mats are to the, when their shoulders are to the mat. Now both wrestlers in the ring. Buddy Rose, Matt Bourne.
I don't know what Buddy's problem there is. His real problem is going to be Matt Bourne.
Come to tight. Yes. Oh, yes.
There's a full moon out tonight.
Yes,
sir.
Moon over Portland, Oregon tonight. Yes, sir. And the crowd goes wild. Buddy Rose.
Oh, atomic drop.
Here comes the atomic drop. Oh. Oh, and right over the top rope goes Buddy Rose on the floor. Here comes Matt Bourne after him. A hard stomp to the back. Buddy Rose in trouble now again.
Here we go. Oh, he's going to use one of those folding chairs.
And oh, smash burst into that steel chair at ringside. Matt Bourne's starting to have his way again. Buddy Rose, not so cocky now.
I'd land right on the nose. Oh, Bourne following Rose right in there. Just used the lacing on his boot to rake right across Buddy's face.
Now Matt Bourne twisting that head of Buddy Rose, applying a lot of pressure. Buddy Rose really feeling the effects of it now. He's taking a few good shots by Matt Bourne.
Well, we're actually picking up where the first fall left off now with Matt Bourne in full control. Buddy may have waited a little too long here.
Sandy Barr checking that arm. If it goes down a third time, this match will be over.
No.
Almost. A little sign of life there. Matt Bourne now. Oh, stretching that head way back. And Buddy Rose, back first out of the floor.
Well, he smacked his head on the concrete down there when he landed.
The fans love it.
Remember, there's no disqualification in this particular match.
Sandy Barr counting. Rose has got till 20 to get back into the ring. The count continues. Here comes Buddy Rose into the ring. Matt Bourne with it. Goes for left. Left and right. A hard left to the forehead.
He's working on Buddy right now. Look at this. Suplex.
Front face. Go for the suplex. Here it comes. Oh, a hard suplex. Matt Bourne coming off the rope. And it drives the knee right to the forehead of Playboy Buddy Rose. What a vicious match
Matt
this has Bourne been so far.
Bourne in full control. Buddy Rose finally, he kicks out of that one. But he is exhausted. He's hurt. He's
and
bleeding.
Now right back to that head twisting, that neck twisting. Very effective. Fans yelling, break it. Matt Bourne having his way now. Sandy Barr watching closely for any sign of a submission on the part of Playboy Buddy Rose, who's in a very bad way right now. Matt Bourne in full control.
You bet he is. Buddy Rose checking that arm of Buddy Rose. Oh, I don't know, Stan. You think this might...
How many times that arm come down?
I don't know.
Is Buddy Rose out?
It's hard to tell.
Well, we'll find out right now. One, two. Matt Bourne decides, no. I'm going to finish him off now.
Now, that could be a mistake. He had Bourne beaten right there.
He's going to go for another super. Boy, did you hear that?
Yeah, he landed with a smash, right?
Matt Bourne coming up the top rope, the old cannonball.
Oh.
Yes.
This has got to be it.
The old Tony Bourne cannonball. Two. Oh, boy. Matt Bourne really wants to cripple him up and put him away for good.
He wants to punish him some
more. Buddy Rose completely out of it. Matt Bourne could have defeated him on two different occasions right now. He had him totally at his mercy. Now go
wait
for
a minute.
The chair.
Buddy just pulled.
Buddy Rose with a pair of brass knucks or some foreign object. Right to the throat with a foreign object.
I think he knocked him out with that.
Yes, he did. Buddy Rose pulled out a foreign object out of his trunks and drove it straight to the jaw of Matt Bourne, and Matt Bourne is completely out. Buddy Rose will be declared the winner. Remember, this is a no disqualification match.
Now, that was that he had a piece of steel.
And now he attacked Sandy Barr. Buddy Rose with a chair across the back. Really giving it to Matt Bourne. Oh, right across the back.
We're going to have to get some help in here.
Buddy Rose completely out of control. We're going to need some help in here.
Oh, no.
He goes after Sandy Barr again. Buddy Rose pressing that steel chair to the neck.
We're definitely going to have to get some help. He could really do some serious damage here to Bourne.
Now to the throat.
On his throat.
Sandy Barr is out of it. Buddy Rose now with the chair again.
Matt's just trying to get out of the way. I'm
surprised
he can even move.
Matt's fighting back. Oh, boy, I'll tell you, talk about guts. Matt Bourne with very little strength left. Now Tommy Pritchard making an appearance here. Tommy Pritchard realizing what happened, probably watching it on the monitor in the dressing room. It took how Matt Bourne ever came up.
Buddy Rose is surrounded by security down there.
This match is over. Sandy Barr was attacked by Playboy Buddy Rose with that steel chair.
I don't know. You think Sandy Barr is going to let the decision stand when he was attacked by...
I really don't know what Sandy's going to do. Yes, he has no other choice, Don, but to give the match to Buddy Rose, despite of him getting hit and attacked by Buddy Rose.
I see. He's got that. It's a steel wrapped in that...
Right.
In that pair of brass wrapping the bandage.
And Sandy Barr has no other choice but to give it, being that it's a no disqualification, whether he hit the referee or not, that wasn't a stipulation or it wasn't... There's no disqualification no matter what. Anything goes, and that's exactly what it means. Anything goes. Buddy Rose, the winner of our main event tonight. Fortunately, Matt, looks like he's going to be all right. Despite taking a severe beating, he'll feel it a lot more after he cools off. You can bet on that.
Well, it was that shot to the chin, of course, with the with that steel wrapped in that wrapping. That got it for Buddy Rose.
You know, that was a vicious match. You know, for a while, I thought that Matt, I'll tell you, he took a few good shots with the chair, and this goes to show you the physical condition Matt Bourne is in, and all these wrestlers are, to be able to take that kind of abuse and still come back, still survive. It's hard for the ordinary person to realize that, but when that adrenaline is flowing and you're all sweaty and warm, and you realize your health is in danger, your physical being is in danger, your life is in danger, you can do a lot of miraculous things to defend yourself and protect yourself.
Well, when somebody's got a piece of steel wrapped around a bandage-type wrapping and lays that on your chin coming up from the floor, Well, there's not a whole lot you can do about that.
Well, you know, this was Buddy Rose's type of match. And, you know, like I said a while ago, when it is said anything goes, that's exactly what it means, anything goes. Even though the referee was attacked, he could not renege and give the match on a disqualification because there isn't one. It's unfortunate, but that's the way the match was. That's the way it was made, and that's the way the rules are, and that's all there is to it. But unfortunately, Buddy Rose prevailed. Matt Bourne, a little over eager. We saw him on three different occasions. He had Buddy Rose completely out. He could have defeated him. He wanted to put him away for good. He wanted to cripple him. And consequently, Buddy Rose had the foreign object hidden in his trunks. And the cagey, sneaky type of wrestler he is prevailed, knocked Matt Bourne completely out, and won the match.
Well, you're right. It was Buddy Rose's kind of match. And Buddy Rose is victorious in our main event tonight. We'll be right back with an interview right after this.
It's Tom Peterson's direct to you. Furniture at truckload prices. Save $100, your choice. Buy this beautiful full-size sectional, only $498. Or buy this sofa love seat combination. Both pieces, only $498. Both sectional and sofa love seat covered in rugged, durable Herculon. Or if you prefer, buy the sectional as a sleeper or the sofa as a sleeper. Only $99 more. Now that's Tom Peterson's.
Wherever you are in Portland, there's a Jim Fisher used car center near you. Choose from more than 300 quality used cars. Here are some examples of bargains at Jim Fisher Datsun Mall 205.
Here's a 79 Datsun.
To say one thing. Congratulations for being able to defend yourself. I've never seen anybody take such a beating like you did and be able to come back. I explained that a while ago, but you realize that you're in danger, and it's very admirable the way you did that.
Well, Sam, there's one thing that me and Buddy Rose do have in common, and that's that we like to fight a lot alike. But there's one difference. They're just two different caliber of people, and I'm not saying that I'm any better than him, but I just think I have a little more confidence in myself than him. But it's twice, two weeks in a row now he's brought out lead. Now you tell me, Stan, you tell me if you couldn't hurt somebody seriously, that would not kill somebody with that.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is solid lead under here. It's heavy, solid lead.
See, what Buddy Rose does is he goes back in his dressing room and he takes this out of his bag or wherever he gets it from, and he sticks it way down deep in his pants, see? And then when he gets out there, he sees the opportune time, and he reaches way down there in his pants, and he pulls it out and uses it on whoever, and whoever just happens to be me this time. But instead of hiding it down in your panties, buddy, I've got a great idea. A great idea that if you are the tough man that you think you are, you try to come across to being, put a coal miner's glove on top of that high post in the ring and get in there with me. And then we'll see who uses the lead on who. And that's not to mention, Stan, a cage match in Eugene. Friday night, brother, a cage match in Eugene against none other than the Playboy Buddy Rose himself. Now, Rose, you recoup from Friday night in Eugene. You think about that coal miner's glove match, because I'll be damned if I put up with this kind of crap from you. Anymore.
Next Saturday night, we'll be back with our main event. Mr. Ebony will take on none other than Tommy Pritchard. Back to Don.
Okay, Stan. Well, tonight promised to be exciting and with no holds barred, and that's exactly the way it happened. And next Saturday night, as you say, Tommy Pritchard and Mr. Ebony going at it, and we want you here, too.
And Matt Bourne has challenged.
Absolutely. That's a challenge, Buddy Rose.
Buddy Rose.
This is Don Koss along with Stan Stasiak. Thanks so much for joining us on Portland Wrestling from the Portland Sports Arena.
Tom Peterson's, with two locations, both at 82nd and Foster Road. and by Jim Fisher's four used car locations where you can always get the best deal. And by Miller's Meister Brau, tastes as good as a Budweiser at a better price.
Stay tuned next for Star Search.
An emergency sacrifice sale of rental return furniture at Grand Prix. We're way overstocked, so prices have been slashed throughout the store. Like this group of quality-built sofas, now just $99 to $199. Pick the style that's right for you, then make your best deal ever. If new, some of these sofas would cost up to $800. Now through Monday, take advantage of bargain prices during Grand Prix's sacrifice sale of rental return furniture. Grand Prix, where instant credit makes buying even easier.
Smart buyers agree, it's Grand Prix.
Don't miss Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous every Sunday night at 11.